Before we start this lesson, let me ask you some questions. Whenever we think of an animal or a bird, a particular quality comes to our mind. What are all those qualities? Why do you think street entertainers prefer monkeys to other household pets like cats and dogs? In this lesson, we will come across some difficult words. Meaning of some difficult words are given here. Discreet, that does not attract attention. Squeal, long, loud, high cry. Slaughtering, walking in a slow and relaxed manner. Adorn, to decorate. Panting, breathing heavily. Indignant, expressing anger and surprise. Ridding, freeing. Deftly, quickly and skillfully. Glee, feeling of excitement. Anguish, suffering caused by pain or worry. Plunged, fell suddenly forward or downward. Now let's first of all read the poem. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry, I could not travel both. And be one traveler, long I stood and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Then took the other as just as fair, and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear. Though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. And both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day. Yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. I shall be telling this with a sigh. Somewhere, ages and ages hence, two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less travelled by, and that has made all the difference. Now let us enjoy the mischief of troublesome monkey Tutu. Narrator's grandfather bought Tutu from a street entertainer for 10 rupees. Grandfather had weakness for keeping unusual pets. Grandmother first objected of having a monkey in the house because already there were several white mice and small tortoise. But when grandfather told it is a little girl monkey, grandmother gave in because she always wanted a little girl in the house. She believed that girls were less troublesome than boys. But Tutu proved it wrong. Tutu had bright eyes. Her teeth were pearly white. Aunt Ruby, who never had already suffered from the presence of grandfather pets, but it was Zehra, and aunts and uncle had to put up with all pets. One day, Aunt Ruby announced that she had become engaged. And the name of the boy was Rocky Fernandez. a school teacher from Goa. He was a tall, firm-jawed and good-natured man. Everyone agreed at Aunt Ruby's choice. One day, narrator overheard Aunt Ruby and Rocky going to bazaar to bring engagement ring. Narrator also decides to go along, but Aunt Ruby does not want him around. So he decides to follow them strictly at a discreet distance. Discreet means that does not attract attention. Tutu also became aware that a mission of some importance, and she also decided to follow. In the crowded bazaar, narrator followed Aunt Ruby and Rocky without being noticed. They entered a large jewelry shop, but accidentally they spotted narrator. Aunt Ruby wasn't look pleased to see narrator. When Aunt Ruby was going through diamond rings, Tutu also slipped into the shop, and she wore one of the diamond necklaces of the shop and ran away from the shop. Everybody tried to stop her, but she wasn't listening. Jeweler, Rocky, narrator, several bystanders joined in the chase to catch Tutu. She created huge mess in the bazaar and finally left it and took a road leading in the direction towards the house. But she was knowing that if she would be caught, she would be locked up in the home. So she decided to end the chase by ridding herself of the necklace. So she deftly removed it from the neck and threw it in the small canal. All the people who were in the chase jumped into the canal. Finally, after 20 minutes, Rocky found the necklace and gave it to the jeweler. Finally, the ring was bought, an engagement and wedding date was announced. Few days before the wedding, narrator again found Tutu. This time she was in the kitchen helping grandmother for preparing wedding cake. When grandmother wasn't looking, she added various herbs, green chilies, bitter gourd seeds and eggshells. Some guests were not seen for several days after wedding who ate that cake. Most people thought it had an interesting flavor. So in this way, Tutu didn't change at all. She kept on doing mischiefs. So I think you also don't want such type of mischievous pet in your home. Here we end the story. Now let's quickly recapitulate the story. The story is about the mischiefs of a troublesome monkey. Grandfather bought Tutu from a street entertainer for sum of rupees 10. Grandmother first objected, but later she gave in. Tutu was a pretty little monkey with bright eyes. Her teeth were pearly white. One day, Aunt Ruby announced that she had become engaged and wants to marry Rocky Fernandez, a school teacher in Goa. Then Aunt Ruby and Rocky went to bazaar. Tutu followed them and also the narrator. They went in a jewelry shop to buy engagement ring. Tutu ran away with a necklace from the jewelry shop. All the people start chasing her. The monkey throws the necklace into the canal. And finally, after 20 minutes search, Rocky gave it back to the jeweler. After some days, monkey was found making cake for wedding with grandmother. When grandmother is not looking, the monkey adds in it eggshells, spices, herbs, etc. After marriage, many guests were not seen for many days. Who ate that cake? Now, based on this lesson, here is a short assignment for you. Thank you.